Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. So if you're hearing a very scratchy voice right now, that is because this past Monday, my husband and I went to a big amusement park in Germany. We went to the Europa Park, which is just this huge park. It's really, really fun. But we went on so many roller coasters. I am just a roller coaster freak. Like, I could go on the big rides like all day. And I screamed my head off and I ended up losing my voice because I guess I kind of like damaged my vocal cords. Today I've got a fragrance video for you. You guys, I am just so into fragrance at the moment. I've made quite a few new purchases. If you saw my last perfume haul video, I'll try and remember to, or perfume collection video. So I've added six new fragrances to my collection since that, which I know is kind of a lot. Like, I need to really slow down a little bit on the purchasing. This is called Samsara. And this is by the house of Guerlain. Now, Guerlain is a French perfumist house. Obviously, you guys know probably a lot of their makeup, but they actually started as a perfume house. Guerlain, they don't make, like, it's not a brand, it's not like a designer brand that also makes perfume. They just make perfume, and now they also make cosmetics and stuff. So they're not like a clothing designer or something. So they're really just a beauty house. They started with some very classic fragrance. Like, they have been around a really, really long time. This is what I'm actually wearing right now, but I'm just gonna, oh, you guys, I wanted to try a classic fragrance from Guerlain. Now, this one is not super, super old. They do have some really classic fragrances that have been around for like a really long time. So this one is not as old as some of the ones they have. So this came out in 1989. This is an absolute classic from the house of Guerlain. And I have never owned any Guerlain fragrances myself. They're very, very well done perfumes. Like, they're just masters of their art. And I totally think that Samsara is absolute perfection. This is just a masterpiece, I think. And that's why I think it's still around. Like, you can still buy this. And this is such a timeless perfume. Now, they have changed the bottle of this. The original bottle that was launched was this kind of red looking bottle. What I actually read is that this bottle, the reason that they changed the bottle is because this is actually how Guerlain fragrances were sold, like in the very beginning when the brand got started. They're going back to that classic Guerlain shape. It is such a rich and complex fragrance. I think this was like pretty popular in the 90s. This is a perfume that my mother actually wore. So if she's watching this, I'm kind of curious to see if she actually remembers this, but she used to wear this fragrance, smelling this on my mom and thinking that she smelled really, really good wearing this. Like, I obviously didn't have a perfumer's nose or anything like that. I didn't have a true appreciation for fragrance, but I remember smelling this on my mom and it just smells so beautiful on her. And so this kind of is a nostalgic fragrance to me because it is something that I do remember when I was younger. It's an oriental floral, kind of a woodsy floral. I know there's jasmine in here, bergamot, there's sandalwood, vanilla, tonka, and amber as the base notes. And I can really pick up on the jasmine. Also, there's narcissus in here and violet carnation. Anyway, there's so many notes in here, but the sandalwood is very prominent, so I can really smell that woodsy sandalwood base. There was like a commercial for it, and it's like this woman walking through this like sand dune, and it's just like this sort of oriental music, and then it just says Samsara. You guys, this perfume is so, so beautiful, so timeless. I think this is an absolute classic, beautiful, sophisticated, grown-up scent, but I can definitely see this being perfect for a like formal night out if you're going to the opera or something like that. It projects a lot, so it has great sillage, and the lasting power of this is really, really, really good. I picked up a second perfume also from the house of Guerlain, and this is one of their newer releases. So this was originally launched in 2014, and this is from their Aqua Allegoria line. I mean, look at this packaging. It is beautiful. It has that similar sort of bottle, but this one has that honeycomb, like golden honeycomb, on the top, and this top here, there's a bee on it. I don't know if you can see that there. There's like a little bee on there. I think it's beautiful. I love these bottles. I think they're stunning. And the Aqua Allegoria line is one that they always release new scents. I think they started it like I said, a few years ago. This one is from 2014. And each year they will release a couple new scents and they will discontinue some of the older ones. This one, like I said, is one from their permanent range because I guess it does really well. And this is the Limon Verde. So Limon Verde. And this one is just a super fresh, lemony, summery, just really happy scent. Now, the Aqua Allegorias are known to be really sort of light and fresh and fun, sort of more youthful scents. Like this one is definitely very like grown up, like beautiful, sophisticated. And the Aqua Allegoria line is also, it's a beautiful fragrance line, but they're just supposed to be lighter and fresher and a little bit easier to wear. So the top notes are Mexican lemon and orange. And the heart notes are Caipirinha, Accord, and Fig. And that's really what I smell. Like this fragrance smells like Caipirinha. You guys know the drink with the, I think it's cachaca, or is it cachaça? And the limes crushed up with the brown sugar. There's also fig in here, which is not dominant. You guys know, I've said that before, I'm not crazy about fig fragrances. And the base notes are Venezuelan tonka bean. This is such a fresh, like, super fresh, happy, lemony, lemon-lime fragrance that just totally reminds me of that Caipirinha cocktail. If you, it just reminds me of like sitting on a terrace in the summer drinking Caipirinha. The only negative thing about these Aqua Allegorias is that the projection, the sillage, is not super great. Like this one definitely projects way more and they're not super long lasting. But if you know that going in, then just you won't be as disappointed. Now I don't know if this is an Eau de Parfum. No, these are Eau de Toilette. This is 125 milliliter, and I feel like the price point for this is good because you're getting a lot of product in here. Okay, and the next one that I picked up is another Serge Lutens. Now, oh my gosh, you guys know I'm a big fan of this house. I love the fact that he doesn't gender his fragrances. And this is Une Bois Vanille. So in French, that means like the vanilla forest. And that also hints at what this is about. So this was launched in 2003. This is the 15 milliliter. Here you can see the classic bottle. It's kind of a different vanilla fragrance. And I realized I didn't really have any really vanilla based fragrance. Like some of them have vanilla in it, but one that's really super vanilla, I didn't have one in my collection. And this one is kind of different because it's vanilla accords and woodsy accords mixed together. It's a different take on vanilla. It's like, I feel like it's vanilla in a bit more of a grown-up way. It's definitely vanilla and sweet, like the coconut, the beeswax, the tonka bean, the almond, and the vanilla, and the licorice and stuff. Those are all very sweet, like very gourmand scents. So the guaiac wood and the sandalwood are like the woodsy notes, and they just make the vanilla not so boring, not something like Victoria's Secret vanilla lace, you know, something like really basic. It just makes it a little bit more refined. It makes it smell more niche. It makes it smell more high end. You know, it is a niche brand, and I feel like his fragrances are all very unique. Like, I don't feel like I can replicate this scent easily with another. Comptoir Sud Pacifique, and this is a niche fragrance house out of France. Sud Pacifique, so it's supposed to be like South Pacific inspired scents. I think they do make like a range of fragrances, but they're kind of known for their like really tropical notes. This one just really intrigued me. This is the Vanille Banane, or Vanille Banane. So vanilla banana. And this is an Eau de Toilette. This is actually the large size because I could not buy this locally. I ordered this one online again because this was a blind purchase. So I really wanted to try this because I love the scent of bananas. Like I love bananas. I love banana smoothies. And I watched a ton of reviews on people reviewing this, and a lot of people said that, you know, the banana note in here is very dominant. It reminds them of like a banana cake. And that just sounded really fun. Like this is not a fragrance to be taken seriously. I thought this would be just a fun fragrance, like now for the summer, just to wear. It's kind of tropical smelling. This was so disappointing because it does smell like immediately when you spray it, you can definitely smell a very dominant banana note. That banana note is so fleeting. I have never had a perfume where the top note just like goes away after about 10 seconds. I just sprayed that and I could immediately smell bananas and vanilla. And now all I smell is vanilla. Like the banana is just gone. Like I don't even know how that is possible, because when you first spray it out, the banana is very dominant and you can smell it. It smells like a Chiquita, like a really ripe Chiquita banana, or like those little banana marshmallow candies or something like that. But it's gone. Like I can't smell the banana anymore. It's very disappointing because like the main reason I wanted to buy this is because I don't have like a banana fragrance. The reason I really wanted a banana fragrance is because I love the Body Shop banana range, which has just come back in. This is like a limited edition. It came out, I think, last year the first time. It's 100% vegan range. They have like, this is the body yogurt. Oh my God. Why don't they just release this as a perfume? I would wear this like all the time. It smells so good. This smells like, seriously, like bananas mashed up. So I was kind of hoping that, you know, I would get some of that similar banana scent, but this is really just like vanilla. And I've tried layering. I've tried like doing this as a body cream and then putting this on top, but really like the banana here just dissipates so fast. I really can't recommend this, unfortunately. So, and then another very cheap fragrance that I picked up is this one by Elizabeth Arden. You can see I've actually used quite a bit. So this is the 100 ml. And Elizabeth Arden is a very, very affordable perfume brand. So I wanted like a really inexpensive, quickly put it on before the gym perfume because, you know, I go to the gym quite a lot and like I go 3 times a week to CrossFit and I like to smell nice, but I'm not gonna wear like a really heavy scent like Samsara. So I wanted something really fresh and light, and this is from their green tea range. So Elizabeth Arden has quite a few of these green tea flankers. The original green tea perfume, the Eau de Parfum by Elizabeth Arden, the nose behind it is Francis Kurkdjian, who is now a famous perfumer. Like you guys might have heard some of his fragrances like Baccarat Rouge or Oud Satin Mood and Oud Silk Mood by the Maison Francis Kurkdjian. He was actually in the nose who created the original green tea for Elizabeth Arden. And that one is a really nice, like fresh, very vibrant, very green scent. I saw that they had this flanker green tea cucumber. I love the scent of cucumber. I used to have this like cucumber scented deodorant. And I thought this would be such a great like gym perfume because it just smells fresh and clean, almost kind of in that soapy direction, like green, fresh, very citrusy. It says the top notes are citrus and cucumber, and those are the main notes. The heart notes are watermelon and violet leaf, and then the base notes are amber and umbrette seed. But really the main notes that I get from this, the cucumber and the citrus. This is just, oh my God, this is like my sort of go-to gym fragrance at the moment, because I feel like this is a fragrance that it's not too strong. The longevity of this is not super great. So, but I don't care because after the gym, I take a shower anyway. But if you like go to the gym and you shower at the gym, this would be like a great fragrance to put on after you get out of the shower. And the last purchase that I made, and this was actually my very first like fragrance that's really geared more towards men. Like this is marketed solely to men. This is not marketed as a unisex fragrance. I don't care. I feel like fragrances are unisex by nature. You just like what you like. This is Azzaro Wanted by Night. This came out in 2018. I think this was quite talked about in the fragrance community. This is actually a flanker to the original Azzaro Wanted perfume. I don't have the original Wanted, but a lot of people said that this is actually nicer. And this is such a gorgeous perfume. I think this is an Eau de Parfum. Yes, it is. This is the 50 milliliter. I love the bottle. It's supposed to be like a, what is that called? Like the barrel of a gun or? I don't know, just very sort of, you know, masculine, gendered looking perfume, but I think it's really cool. I like that. I mean, I'm not like into guns, but I think it's a very cool, like, it looks like a shell, or I don't know, even know what that is called, but it looks very cool. At first I was like trying to screw it this way because I thought like I have to unscrew it, but it really is just the top here like that. The main notes in here are cinnamon, tobacco, red cedarwood, and I think there's also a citrus in here of some kind. I think it's lemon and orange. And then the tobacco and the cinnamon is just so gorgeous. Like the cinnamon is what really drew me in. It's a very, very spicy, rich fragrance. It has a sweetness to it, not like sickly sweet, not like super, super feminine sweet, but there is a sweetness to it. If you just smell like raw tobacco, not the one that's been like lit from a cigarette, but like the kind that you put into a pipe or something, like men who smoke pipes, and you know, that kind of has like a sweetness to it, and there's a lot of spices in here. The cinnamon in here is very dominant, so if you don't like cinnamon, then you might not like the scent, but it's gorgeous. Like, and that citrusy note gives it a certain freshness. The lasting power in this is really, really good. I have worn this, like, this is kind of more of an evening fragrance, I think. Just know that this scent is one that really changes as it dries down. I feel like the top notes are just gorgeous on this, and I wish the top notes last a little bit longer. I like the dry down as well, but I feel like the top notes and the mid notes are really where this fragrance performs the nicest. As it dries down, it gets a little bit more masculine and a little bit more basic. It's a beautiful scent, and I think definitely women could get away with wearing this. Like, I have worn this quite a few times, and I've never had anyone say to me, oh, you smell like a guy, or you smell like a dude, or anything like that. When you go fragrance shopping, like, look into the aisle of the other gender. If you're a guy, like, there's nothing stopping you from going into the women's part where the women's fragrances are. And if you're a woman, like, check out the men's fragrances, because there's some really gorgeous very unisex fragrances that could be worn by both. So I want to know from you guys what new fragrances you have discovered. Put that in the comments. Let me know what your recent favorites are, if you've like discovered a new brand, like a niche brand that you're so into. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.